Joe Giacalone. Joe, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Joe is a former NYPD detective and friend of the show. How you doing, Joe? Good morning.
Good, Bill. How are you?
I'm doing great. So you heard that, you know, Eric Scott was talking about this in the news, these two cops that got themselves in trouble because the guy had his hands up clearly on the video. Here's my question to you. And you and I have talked about this before. I despite that some will throw out these statistics and say, I love that, you know, Matt Welsh at Reason Magazine loves to do this. He and I battle on Twitter once in a while. He says, no, it's a very safe year for cops. You know, the numbers of deaths are coming down. And I say that when you look at the real stats of how many times officers are assaulted, how many times officers are killed in the line of duty, that this narrative against cops is incredibly strong. And my question to you is, Why do you think, like, little instances like this where they are throwing the book at these two cops who roughed up a guy who said the guy went for his gun? Why does that happen? What do you do to guard against that? And why do you think that culturally we grab on the one bad incident and that becomes the label for law enforcement?
Well, I mean, this is what happens. I mean, we always try to tell people not to paint the entire group with a broad brush, but we end up doing that in every police incident that happens. You know, 900,000 law enforcement officers across the country, and, you know, you have one or two bad apples. Listen, I mean, I'm always a pro cop kind of guy, but you know what? We really do need to look at our recruitment, selection, and training of officers. We have to look at, you know, how much we've dropped standards to get police officers to be inclusive and to include everybody into that mix. But we have to be careful because people are slipping through the cracks that should never get this job in the first place.
And why do you think that's? Is that because of political correctness? I mean, are we looking at our police officers and saying that, you know, we'll adjust the standards based on sex, based on race?
Well, I mean, it has a variety of things. You have, not only do you have to deal with the sex and race and stuff like that, but you got to understand something. There's a lot of people that don't want this job. So when they wanted to be inclusive, they wanted to get everybody. Like, listen, if I was trying to be a cop 30 years ago, I would have never made it because I was too short, right? You had to be about 6 foot tall in order to get.
No kidding.
You know,
they had
specific rules on that. So I benefited from some of those rules. I mean, that will have to do with height, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But listen, there is a definite problem that we have in our recruitment and selection and the psychological testing of some of these people. I mean, you look at some of these incidents and you shake your head.
What about, what do you say that you know, and this has been coming up a lot, that the cops in certain cities, I mean, cities in New Jersey, like Newark, Camden, these are dangerous places. They're more dangerous at night. You got a drug problem. You got a gang problem. You know, and the politicians love to come in and out of these cities and say, oh, you know, Obama was in Newark saying, oh, no, things are getting better. We're working on prisoner reentry. You know, Christie goes to Camden and says, hey, things are getting better. And yeah, statistically, they may be. But the question I have for you is, is this a real phenomenon that that cops are a little bit more hesitant today to be aggressive on certain arrests because they're worried that some guy with a cell phone is going to put a video out that's going to be viral and that's going to label the cop's job for that week?
Well, it's something that definitely has to be considered because we're seeing spikes in homicides across the country. And, you know, even here in New York City, when you're talking about, like, the removal of stop, question, and frisk, a lot of people say, look, there's no correlation between, you know, crime's still down and stop, question, and frisk is way down. But I try to explain to people they have paid so much money in overtime to put out what I just refer to as blue trees, people standing out there on the street corner. They got horses driving, you know, walking around the city. You have temporary headquarters vehicles parked everywhere because they're just trying to suppress crime with overtime. And this is the problem. So when people say, even a lot of journalists, a lot of reporters, they say, Joe, there's no correlation. It's down. And I try to explain to them they have replaced that stop, question, frisk with just cops standing on a street corner. And that's the real issue there.
So bringing back stop and frisk, everything we've heard from stop and frisk, number one, it was effective. I mean, New York City went from having more than 2,000 murders a year to in the few hundred. I mean, a huge, dramatic difference between Rudy and Mayor Bloomberg. And I think you point to some of the same things in some of the cities in New Jersey that if you had a policy of stop and frisk, just real quick in the little bit of time I have left, what do you say to people that say, no, it's racial profiling?
Yeah, no, I mean, listen, the cops go where the crimes are, wherever those crimes may be. And, you know, the violence that happens, unfortunately, in our inner city neighborhoods, our poor neighborhoods, and that the majority of the people there are people of color. So, listen, I mean, I'm white, and I was working in some of these neighborhoods. If I stopped somebody, people would say racial profile, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, we have to look at things sometimes with common sense and look at it and say, well, if we have a number of white officers that work in a minority neighborhood, then, of course, the numbers are going to be skewed.
Okay. Former NYPD Detective Joe Giacalone. Joe, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Have a great weekend. You and I will certainly be talking very soon. Appreciate your time.
You too, Bill.